Yeah.
Oh, this is the
comp. This is the comp.
This is the comp they played in the last cup when they did so well.
I want to see it.
Prepare for one shots.
Let's look for the one shot. You can see that meteor as well. That was really the thing that Rosita Jones figured out nice and early. Obviously a little bit different now, but for fun, looking to put on a show for all of us here at AWC.
Now we'll have to see what specialization Rosita Jones is playing. In the past, he was known for playing the Flame Cannon and the Fire Starter build, so we can get these combustions off on CMG, who responds immediately with the dispersion. So if Rosita Jones is just sitting there pre-casting fireballs, he's looking for these one-shot setups. Potentially could be playing Greater Pyroblast as well, but we really don't see him play that often.
All right, Whoopi lockdown, crowd control. Rosita with evasive maneuvers avoids the incoming attack and now looks for counter aggression. CMG taking a pounding right now by the team of 4FUN early on. We don't typically see this much pressure against a Restoration Druid, but 4FUN have come out to get a win here early on. Void Shift now forced as well, and this peculiar composition that they pioneered towards the ends of the seasons last year is still working wonders for them and might be the curveball to take the whole tournament. Who knows? But with this kind of pressure, they're looking good.
At Rosita Jones, fireball after fireball, resetting that combustion. And every time he gets that up, it is a scary moment for Get Your Boy Dog. Omnivore now into the Psychic Horror, stunned up, polymorph on Whoopi. Whoopi still vulnerable to the crowd control of Grayson. But you can see Rosita Jones now playing defense. He's going to be spamming out his own polymorph onto Grayson, and that buys Whoopi some time. Get the Life Cocoon on Omnivore and keep him completely healthy.
Here we go. Whoopi's moving in, and when that Mistweaver goes in, you know something's about to go down, but actually gets intercepted. Luckily, on Diminishing Return, now Whoopi starts the crowd control. They've got 10 seconds to kill WizKey. They need damage here, but they polymorph Whoopi up on that Way of the Crane. Good denial by the Mage of Grayson. That was a critical moment in the game that 4FUN looked to try and close. Grayson denies it.
Yep, CMG will ultimately survive with that Iron Bar coming in from Flop, and beautiful peels there by Grayson. It's really going to be up to him. When CMG is being trained down by Omnivore, caught into the Storm Bolt, there's not too much he can do to keep himself alive. Here's a setup. Once again, Rosita Jones deflects with the Polymorph spam, getting CMG in crowd control. Flop pushes in. Dragon's Breath denies it. Rosita Jones, beautiful, beautiful job there, honestly, denying all the aggression coming in from Get Your Boy Dog. And now CMG is the one that's in trouble.
Yeah, CMG ducking around the corner, waiting for Flop to get out of crowd control. Still a lot of pressure being dished out by Omnivore. Obviously, an Arms Warrior into a Shadow Priest is going to be favored to the Arms Warrior. Pair that up with the excellent plays of Whoopi, adding in that Way of the Crane damage, and you've got a formula to find a kill. I really do like this composition. However, Whoopi is going to need to look to extend the match. His mana is not in a great position. If at some point in this game he can find a drink or generate mana to full and make that push later in dampening, I think they will be able to secure a kill against Get Your Boy Dog. Now, on the other hand, basically this entire matchup rides on Grayson. He needs to prevent his Shadow Priest CMG from dying. He needs to set up crowd control like this on Whoopi to execute for a kill, and then have Flop re-engage off the back of it. Flop crossing the map, looking to get some follow-up. The crowd control so far looks good. Omnivore is exposed, and Grayson definitely on point here in game one as they look to try and turn things around.
Yeah, Way of the Crane used by Whoopi, but he's getting crowd controlled on all of it. He needs to get some damage rolling, finally moving in, but the mind control denies the heals. Get Your Boy Dog completely outplaying Whoopi. Now a silence. Does he have anything left? No, he doesn't. That was such a beautiful play by Get Your Boy Dog. Whoopi just completely.
I think we can say, Get Your Boy Dog going to be leading by one. And they're going to try to get themselves on match point for fun. Already having to switch off something that we know Whoopi for in the Monk. Let's see how he can fare on the Druid. And let's see if we get to see him pull off any cheeky plays in Feral Affinity.
So far, he hasn't revealed if he is currently running it or not. Grayson actually catches Whoopi, and this is a bit of an inexperienced moment on Druid to be caught on Polymorph with no stun leading into it. That could have been an opportunity for Grayson's team to get damage going, but Omnivore was already in a good position to avoid the attack, so definitely good awareness on Omnivore's part.
Yeah, now a swap over onto Flop, I believe. He gets Life Gripped away by CMG to stay alive. That Leap of Faith will keep Flop in a favorable position. Barkskin was used and traded out as Rosita Jones did commit his combustion. Now, once again, Rosita Jones is going to be playing that Firestarter Flame Cannon build. We talk about it a lot. Basically, every time he gets a fireball off, it reduces the cooldown of his combustion by 5 seconds. The Flame Cannon, in addition to that, allows his fireball to do more consistent damage. Every time he stands still, he gets a buff, stacking up 4 times. That increases his damage, his stamina, and his range, so he can sit very far away, get these fireballs, get these power blasts off, and it actually allows him to have quite good consistent damage in the match.
All right, Whoopi moves in, gets clotheslined by CMG. This could start a devastating crowd control chain over onto Whoopi with all 3 members locked down. Omnivore isolated, but able to line of sight at the boxes here. Good map selection by the team of four. Fun. Omnivore is defensively carrying the team currently, but he's having his damage inhibited so much due to this defensive requirement off the mistakes of his team. So definitely would like to see Whoopi clean up his game so that Omnivore can engage aggressively.
Yeah, Flop taking some burst and is losing on mana at this particular point in the game. I'm not exactly sure who Getchur Boy Dog is going after. Cyclone now on Whoopi, looking for some damage on Omnivore, who looks to be the target of choice in game number 2, just like in game number 1. But Rosita Jones doing a good job denying a lot of this crowd control with polymorphs of his own, keeping up the consistent pressure on CMG. The need to deny any drinks from Flop. The Warrior and the Fire Mage with this build are going to put out massive damage, and if Flop has to basically go for drinks in this matchup, and on the smaller map, it's going to be really difficult as long as Omnivore and Rosita Jones are paying attention.
One of the main reasons this composition works so effectively for Fun is the sharpened blade ability of the Arms Warrior. You can activate this to increase the damage of your next mortal strike and also have it apply a healing reduction effect of 50% healing reduction to the target. So during that sharpened blade, Rosita then will back up Omnivore with tons of instant pyroblast damage. While that damage is coming in, the healing is reduced by half, and that's why it's so effective. We see a swap over onto Flop. Will he just drop? We see CMG void shift over to stay in the fight, but he's still not topped off. Huge attack by For Fun.
Yep, Rosita Jones doing tons of pressure there with the combustion. Flop's mana is not doing well. Now CMG getting swapped here, trying to help out his team with the Vampiric Embrace. But you can see, once again, Polymorph spam on Grayson. Anytime Grayson pushes in, he gets CC on Whoopi. Rosita Jones is there to back him up and slow down any incoming damage. And it's going to be difficult for CMG to basically solo Omnivore in those situations.
Omnivore looking to try and ramp up, and it does seem to be that they want to go after Flop. Flop, I believe, is running Balance Affinity, so he can go into Boomkin form, which makes him immune to Polymorph and still cast heals. It's very powerful at healing your teammates, not so potent at keeping yourself alive, and For Fun know that weakness of Balance Affinity and are trying to exploit it by switching to Flop with Storm Bolts and that Sharpened Blade combination. So Omnivore and Rosita will switch targets, stun up the healer, and combo Sharpened Blade with Pyroblast to take him out. He needs to try and predict that Stormbolt and get into bear form before it occurs. In the meantime, though, during this lull in the game, Flop manages to escape and regenerate some mana for a later game kill. Crowd control initiated by Getchur Boy Dog. They're gunning down for Omnivore. He retreats back behind the boxes. Whoopi tag teaming over there to start to stabilize, but Rosita was left in midfield, caught by that Ursul's Vortex as Grayson and CMG switch their attention over to him. Whoopi in a good position to recover and avoid crowd control, timing that innervate, making his wild growth free. Good combinations of spells by Whoopi to extend this match. For Fun initiate an attack. That sharpened blade is going to trade for Flop's Iron Bark, but Omnivore did split up his cooldowns. He still has Avatar, so the next sharpened blade will be devastating. CMG needs to be ready for it.
Yeah, Grayson tried to get a free polymorph there on Whoopi using both of his blinks. Unfortunately, was denied. Now a Ring of Frost being cast out of the bash coming in from Flop. Good teamwork coming in from Getchur Boy Dog. It's going to be up to CMG and Flop to really set up the crowd control chains, allowing Grayson to get the Ring of Frost or polymorphs on Whoopi when they can with their stuns. Now another Ring of Frost over onto Flop. CMG gets
this
interrupted.
Could be it.
This could be it. Dispersion was used. He's going to manage to survive with that. Flop might have to use the Iron Bark. That would be a big overlap of fear. More crowd control on Flop. Is there anything else? Rosita Jones looking for the polymorphs, not finding it. Iron Bark was connected, but CMG is still dangerously low.
That was the big punch with the Avatar that Omnivore smartly held on to. Comboed together, forced a critical mistake on Getchur Boy Dog's side. They've overlapped defensive cooldowns, and they're vulnerable now with Dampening having just engaged. Omnivore moves forward. He's got that Sharpened Blade Rosita's got a Meteor. Those combo together quite effectively, but they are getting clotheslined as they look to push across the map. Rosita is being pushed back. Will he be able to stay aggressive? Meteor connects with that sharpened blade, but gets completely denied by Vampiric Embrace of CMG. Now Flop jumping into the fight, looking for crowd control. Whoopi ducks back around the corner, but gets caught by Grayson. Grayson once again with the sneaky polymorphs. Whoopi can't afford these errors. Tons of damage now available potentially here for Rosita. No, not enough. And in the meantime, Rosita actually gets a counterspell on Flop. This could lead some momentum to take down CMG. No follow-up, though. CMG starts to stabilize, activating Void Form, really trying to ramp up his damage, but Whoopi's moving in. What's Whoopi trying to get done here? Flop is trying to retreat away from that pillar, but now he's exposed to Cyclone. Good Cyclone, although premeditated with Iron Bark. Nice read on Flop's side. Rosita now getting counter-pressured as they look to push forward for a kill. They are getting clotheslined.
Yeah, Rosita Jones is going to be coming increasingly vulnerable in this matchup as well. Flop's mana is not doing great. Whoopi's still a little bit ahead if he can keep his team alive. Looking for Tranquility, canceling that immediately. Just getting a little bit of bonus healing there for Omnivore and Rosita Jones, trying to potentially bait out a counterspell from Grayson as he looks for a polymorph on Whoopi once again. But now Grayson with no blinks, not a huge threat to get these blink polymorphs. Whoopi will be able to stabilize and keep his team alive as they push in. They do not want to allow Flop to get a drink. That is the reason why they chose the smaller map. They need to deny the drinks and take advantage of the fact that they have Omnivore with the Mortal Strike effect. Rosita Jones with the consistent damage, which really taxes Flop's mana.
Oh, big Maledict attack here towards CMG. Flop's trying to deal with it, but dampening is ramping up. They may need to overlap. Another Maledict is going to get the dispersion, but that's absorbing all the healing with the Maledict. Omnivore got bursted low as well, and I think this game could be ending shortly. The pressure is really mounting in favor of For Fun. Omnivore senses it. He activates Dive by the Sword to reduce incoming damage and just stay on target. If they can get crowd control on Flop, Ring of Frost is secured. CMG's locked down. Flop breaks out to try and stall this out. A tad bit longer, but will he have enough healing? He's so restricted on mana, he can't afford to pump out regrowths. CMG gets cycloned, trying to stall out diminishing returns and wait for another crowd control attempt towards Flop. Omnivore leaps to deny Flop from drinking. Very important that they do not allow him to regenerate mana. Whoopi has a significant lead in that regard, and this is looking better and better for For Fun.
Yeah, Flop had to trade out his trinket in that last exchange, but because CMG had to use his Void Shift instantaneously at the beginning of the game, it's actually rotated off of cooldown, which is something you don't normally see. So CMG, he has that reset. Vampiric Embrace will carry him until that point. Dispersion almost available as well. Omnivore now getting swapped to. Whoopi with no trinket for a few seconds. Maybe they could get some crowd control, but no, the Iron Bark will likely deny the kill, but Grayson doing work with the Ray of Frost has to get shut down by Rosita Jones. Beautiful polymorph from Flop, denying the heals from Whoopi. Grayson looking for some crowd control. Whoopi goes into stealth to deny it. Now Flop pushing forward, finds the Cyclone on Whoopi. Omnivore very vulnerable in defensive stance, going to be running behind the pillar, just trying to stay alive.
All right, Rosita Jones getting peeled away by Grayson. He's really trying to slow down this attack, completely negating it, and now potentially building momentum for his team. Although now getting counter-engaged, both these teams continue swinging. They're almost completely tapped on mana for both sides, with dampening reaching 25%. Flop trying to sneak away from the fight. Rosita sees him and is looking to deny it, but I'm not sure if he'll be able to. Ignite triggers the explosion of Living Bomb, and now Flop gets denied on that. They walk into crowd control. Nice moves by Omnivore. Both healers in crowd control. Both teams in trouble. CMG trades first to secure his own life moving forward, but that Maledict soaks up a lot of healing. Omnivore is still digging in. Void Shift available and likely needs to be traded, and it will towards Grayson, but Omnivore is staying on target. All of the healing is reduced by 28% now, and the damage of Omnivore is not going anywhere.
Rosita Jones just got his combustion off cooldown as well, and Flop, he does not have the mana to deal with this. If Rosita Jones can get the damage rolling, it could be scary. In the meantime, Omnivore getting low. Polymorph on Whoopi. Omnivore has to go out of line of sight. If they could just find one good moment on CMG, they can close out the game. Rosita Jones just needs a good, well-timed combustion, but with a fear on Whoopi, Omnivore still in so much trouble. Get your boy dog looking to claim game number two. Omnivore, can you survive? Iron Bark available for Whoopi, but it gets shut down by the bash from Flop. Get your boy dog. Dog staying calm, cool, and collected.
Cannon and, I know this was a joke, but Flame Cannon and...
No, it wasn't. I just don't know much about Tinder. The gates are now open. Getchur Boy Dog moving on through. They need just one more win to take the series.
Yeah, there was a few close calls for CMG in the last game, and I think it for fun just cleans up the gameplay just a little bit. Actually, Whoopi opting for Relentless, I think, this game, which is an adaptation from the first, so when he does get caught in these polymorph chains, they aren't going to be as extended, but that does mean if he does get caught in a polymorph and it gets followed up by Silence and Fear, it is crowd control he has no chance of getting out of. And Omnivore getting low already. Whoopi having to use the Iron Bark instantaneously. Safeguard gets procced. Omnivore has to run away. And those CC chains he can't trinket out of become very scary as the game goes on longer.
Orphan had advantageous position throughout the last game, but suddenly had it flipped in favor of Getchur Boy Dog. So it's definitely the case that Getchur Boy Dog can close this out. Good coordination by Rosita and Whoopi to lock Flop down in crowd control, but Mass Dispel support from CMG denies that chain from continuing, which now means Flop can easily start to recover. Whoopi knows this, so he opts to use Cyclone on CMG, denying him from being topped off completely and preventing him from dealing damage for a few seconds. Flop jumping into the fight, stunning up Omnivore, holding him inside of that frozen orb of Grayson. Good combination of abilities there. Nice coordination by the team of Getchur Boy Dog, but not enough damage really to back up off the end of it. Now a polymorph is secured onto Whoopi. This could be dangerous for Omnivore. He is likely to opt to retreat away. Although getting rooted up and snared, Whoopi is now no longer crowd controlled, so Omnivore is taking this opportunity to go back and attack. And CMG actually playing Void Elf, using that racial to teleport right next to Whoopi. I don't think that was something that he saw coming. A bit unfortunate that nothing ended up happening off the back of that play, but definitely something to look out for moving up forward.
At the beginning of the game on Dalaran Sewers, 4FUN was finding most of their pressure, most of their momentum by making swaps to Flop. And I don't know if it's just Flop's positioning playing too far away for them to take advantage of that, but these games where they're not swapping to him, I really want to see them try to punish Flop a little bit more. Whoopi pushing forward, landing the bash, looking for potentially a Hibernate or Cyclone. Isn't going to be able to find it, but casting Hibernate forces Flop to get out of bear form and allows Rosita Jones to land the polymorph. That's a really good setup that Mage and Druid can do together. If there's a Druid who's just camping in bear form, you cast Hibernate and polymorph at the exact same time, and no matter what happens, he is going to have to eat some crowd control, because if he sits in bear, he gets hibernated. If he shifts out, he eats the polymorph. So you see high-level Mage Druid gameplay there from both Flop and Grayson, or Rosita Jones and Whoopi.
We see some pretty equal trades cooldown-wise. The mana is also evening out. It's anyone's match here in game number 3, but Getchur Boy Dog are on match point and look to advance in the upper bracket, the highest-ranked team on the ladder. Nice catch here by Whoopi, hibernating up Flop. You can definitely see him starting to make some good trades on that Restoration Druid substitute of his own. Now trying to jump across the fight, keep the crowd control chain going, but the damage gets denied by CMG's Vampiric Embrace, allowing his damage to heal his entire team and stabilize through that extended crowd control chain. Good cooldown usage by CMG, definitely carrying the team, and it is now their turn to lead the charge.
Yep, Grayson looking for some crowd control on Whoopi. Rosita Jones denies it, nicely done with the double Dragon's Breath onto Grayson and Flop, but no follow-up. Now CMG taking most of the damage. Iron Bark will deflect with the full polymorph, or full cyclone on Whoopi. Omnivore and Rosita Jones, though, really not taking too much damage. For Grayson and CMG need to find a little bit more burst during these crowd control windows. Silence, Ebon Bolt, Omnivore getting lower, and there's the burst I was talking about, exactly what they needed to do. Now Omnivore Cyclone low. Whoopi's in a bad situation. His Iron Bark got Cyclone, so he doesn't get that increased healing. He's going to have to expel more mana to keep him up.
Yeah, nice moves there by Flop, but Cyclone is also expensive. So both these Druids using Cyclone quite frequently is taxing their mana heavily in this fight. There is now an advantage in favor of Whoopi, although he's been sitting on his Innervate for some time. I would like to see him activate that as soon as possible to get it on cooldown and get another one in the fight for mana efficiency. We do see both Rosita and Whoopi push forward to secure crowd control. The counterspell onto CMG dips low. Trades Dispersion overlapped a bit with the Gladiator Safeguard. Typically, you would want to see those spread out, but CMG waited too long to disperse. Now he loses two defensive options and what would have normally have only been one, which will force Flop into an awkward situation. But we do see crowd control on Whoopi, which means that CMG and Grayson want to get attacking towards Omnivore. They get shut down by him, though, denying a lot of damage with that intimidating shout. I would say that For Fun are now in the lead in this match, but they were in the lead in the last one, and Get Your Boy Dog pulled it off. So it's still anyone's match as we get closer to dampening.
Yep, Flop was looking for a drink. Unfortunately, not able to find it, keeping up the heals. Going to stealth once again. Maybe he snuck away. Potentially, Rosita Jones looking to find him, manages to land the Dragon's Breath. Grayson a little bit too late, denying that. If he had gotten that polymorph off just 1 second or half a second earlier, Flop would have been potentially at full mana, and that's a really big deal in a matchup like this. Omnivore, though, getting swapped to. Big crowd control chain onto Whoopi. Polymorph a little late there by Grayson. Ironbark does connect on Omnivore as well as the Die by the Sword. Get Your Boy Dog. That was a nice attempt. They managed to pull out the long cooldown Die by the Sword as well as Ironbark from Whoopi. And this pressure from Get Your Boy Dog is quite heavy.
Yeah, Get Your Boy Dog are stabilizing and pulling the gold points that they need to get from For Fun at a critical point with dampening just beginning. Get Your Boy Dog are looking clean in this series, looking to eliminate For Fun, at least in the upper brackets. We see crowd control initiated by For Fun as they desperately try to pull something together from the pieces of this match. They managed to pull that dispersion. A critical defensive here from CMG. But in the meantime, Grayson, MVP of the series, getting a polymorph, now getting denied, though, equally so by Rosita, unable to really follow up with too much. Innervate gets dispelled during silence. Nice play by CMG, denying that efficiency in terms of mana. And that dispel on Innervate might tie the mana, actually. And momentum is slowly swinging in their favor. Get Your Boy Dogger looking good.
There's a DR fear, full polymorph secured by Grayson. Omnivore all by himself. But they did manage to get the Iron Bark. Polymorph broke. Another polymorph coming in from Grayson. Omnivore gets topped off instantaneously. Good heals there by Whoopi. Now CMG is the one that's in trouble. Without the crowd control, the Mage Shadow Priest is not favored in this match. It's basically Get Your Boy Dog. They're looking for their CC. When they have Bash, they have the Psychic Horror. They have Fear. They can push in, try to get crowd control. Other than that, they try to look to play a little bit defensive by spamming out the polymorphs. Slow down Rosita Jones. But with this combustion, the damage is quite high. 4-4 Fun. And Flop really doesn't have too much mana left to deal with this. Void Shift might be traded out here by CMG, but he's stabilizing. Grayson with the polymorph spam on Rosita Jones. Nice counterspell by Rosita Jones on Flop. That's going to deny his heals. Omnivore getting a little low, though. Frozen Orb gets dropped by Grayson. And now, once again, Get Your Boy Dog. They're pushing in, looking for the game-winning crowd control.
Both teams in trouble here at critical dampening points. Whoopi with a significant mana lead, but he had that in game number two and still lost. So it's definitely not over yet. Flop is still locked down. CMG, the target, has cooldowns to trade and may need to start thinking about it. Flop's mana situation is not looking too great for them. It's For Fun battle for victory. They need to take this if they want to stay in the upper bracket. They have to win three in a row. Quite a tall order for them to take. But in the meantime, Get Your Boy Dog look to just clean it out. We see polymorphs on to Whoopi. Omnivore getting targeted down. He needs another 34 seconds until Die by the Sword is available, which will likely secure his own life for a push in the future. Another 26 seconds on that cooldown as they march forward, still having the momentum. Good crowd control by Whoopi. Grayson gets locked out. He can't support. CMG line of sights avoids a little bit of the attacks of Rosita, but Omnivore is right next to him, still tearing in. And somehow, some way, Flop is healing on fumes. Whoopi still with a gigantic lead. Die by the Sword is going to be available, and For Fun have set themselves up in a great position to close this match.
Yeah, Flop looking for a drink, hiding in plain sight, but Rosita says, I see you, Dragon's Breath, looking for some potential polymorph, but Flop and Capo, I'm not going to be able to find it. Warbanner does get dropped out. Omnivore just trying to help out his healer, avoid some crowd control. CMG forced into the dispersion, and Flop, his mana is not going up at this point. They just need to slow down these drinks. Rosita Jones gets interrupted. They're buying time. Rosita Jones forced into the ice block. Flop actually going to be getting a lot of mana back here, and this is going to put Get Your Boy Dog back into the game. He didn't.
I guess not. That's a little bit unfortunate for Flop.
Overhyped for nothing.
CMG's got Void Shift to trade his health. Rosita now without an ice block means Whoopi needs to keep heal over time effects on two targets. That's going to tax the rest of his mana, moving into deep dampening territory on Hook Point, the smallest map in the pool. You are not going to find drinks, and Flop tried to, but for some reason wasn't actually able to, and that was an advantage that he could have secured but ended up not getting it and may actually cost him the game here. Omnivore in desperation uses intimidating shot on Grayson. He actually uses ice block to break it. He knows this is a desperate situation, but now he gets counterspelled by Rosita. He's not able to back up the team. Flop moves back a tiny bit. CMG has Void Shift still left to his name, but there's no mana in the tank for Flop. There's no mana in the tank for Whoopi. This is cross-kill potential written all over it. Void Shift exchange over with Flop. He's trying to drink Rosita in the back line. Now Rosita gets cleaved down. Whoopi gets caught in a polymorph. Get your Void Dogger trying to close. Omnivore is carrying the team on his back, single-handedly trying to kill CMG while Rosita is pinned down in an ice block, and Omnivore looking like he might be able to do it. Flop is keeping him going, keeping him afloat just a tiny little bit longer, but it's not ultimately going to be enough, and for fun, stay alive in the upper bracket.
Flop, if they can employ it here, because this is a choice that we did not see coming.
This is the first time we're going to see Baby Cakes here today on that Windwalker Monk. Get your Boy Dog, the highest rated ladder team in the tournament, now looking to make a name for themselves in the tournament scene. They took down teams like Method Orange last week and are looking to wreak havoc in the second week of the North American qualifiers to get to that spring finals. They could be a team to look out for, definitely proving themselves in battle. But with this decision, the peculiar swap to Windwalker, we're waiting to see if it pays out. It might. Ice block forced very early on by Rosita Jones, and maybe we're just wrong at the desk and get Baby Cakes in there and he's just going to immediately cook up a win. This is looking good.
Yeah, Touch of Death gets used. They're not out of it yet. Full polymorph on Whoopi. Still crowd control coming in from Get Your Boy Dog. Grayson doing such a phenomenal job. Rosita Jones getting lower. They might be able to take him down. Cauterize does proc. You can see him running around. Flop just having his way with these clones. Get Your Boy Dog just seems like they are in the driver's seat. They are looking to bury for fun.
I mean, maybe they could have picked a smaller map if they wanted to go all-out aggression. They're just not stopping. That gas pedal is down straight to the floor. Lots of damage. Whoopi tries to deny the kill. Will Ironbark be enough while he sits there? Flop gets swapped too. Omnivore out of nowhere tries to catch a kill on Flop as he was playing so aggressive and overextended. That was definitely an opportunity for fun need to try and take, but Flop denies the kill.
Yeah, Flop was just having way too much fun in that game, getting the offensive Cyclones on Rosita Jones, controlling Whoopi up completely, but Rosita Jones, he does not have another ice block for 3 minutes. Cauterize hasn't proc. That's a 5 minute timer as well. So it's going to be difficult for them to survive the next offensive push coming in from Get Your Boy Dog. As soon as they have their cooldowns up, Icy Veins for Grayson in a minute and a half. That's an opportunity for them to push in and try to actually close out the game.
All right, next crowd control on Whoopi could just end the game if Grayson can get it. Whoopi re-stealths. He's invisible to his opponents and he's repositioning right now. That's a nice move by Whoopi. Definitely a high level decision, but Baby Cakes in engages with that paralysis. There's no follow-up though off the back of it. He pre-touch of Karma's the Storm Bolt. Really good plays by Baby Cakes. He's got his Transcendence on top of Rosita's Blink pattern. Baby Cakes definitely some high-level play here on Windwalker. If he can stay on target a little bit longer, Flop's moving in. We see Grayson on the other side. He's going to wrap around the corner, blinking in for crowd control onto two members. Gets denied. Flop looks for follow-up, and he gets denied. Good denial by the team of 4FUN, but Rosita is still falling behind.
Yeah, Grayson actually missed his Ring of Frost there. That's unfortunate because I think that could have actually closed out the game there if they got that crowd control. Rosita Jones was in a lot of trouble. Rosita Jones now almost has Combustion back up. They might be able to make another swap onto Baby Cakes. Baby Cakes has to trade out the Diffuse. Baby Cakes in a lot of trouble. No Touch of Karma, no Diffuse Magic. Ironbark gets traded out. One more swap from Rosita Jones and Omnivore. Baby Cakes could just go down.
Yeah, now he's an exposed target. Get Your Boy Dog had all the momentum and we're in the lead for some time. If they don't get a kill soon, Baby Cake could be in trouble, but they might just do so. Nice triple stun on the trinket. Perfect play by Baby Cakes, but Omnivore, sick play here from Omnivore, stalling out the fight for a couple of extra seconds. Now securing crowd control onto Flop. Both these teams playing out of their minds.
Yep, Rosita Jones, Meteor on Baby Cakes. Decent damage. Baby Cakes has to Transcendence and run away. Rosita Jones chasing him down. Still in a lot of trouble. Baby Cakes does have the Touch of Karma coming up in 6 seconds after that. He's going to be completely fine. Flop did use his trinket, pushing in now. Bash onto Whoopi. Full Cyclone for Polymorph. Rosita Jones gets interrupted, trying to deflect with the Dragon's Breath, the preemptive Ironbark used by Whoopi. If they can continue this chains, Rosita Jones, he really doesn't have anything left. Another Polymorph on Whoopi. Is there anything else? finally gets out of some CC, trying to avoid the Cyclone at all costs. Rosita Jones looking to deny with the Polymorph spam. Rosita Jones barely hanging on, but that Cyclone keeps him frozen at low HP. Diminishing returns falling off of Whoopi. If a Polymorph can get snuck in by Grayson or a Cyclone from Flop, they could just close out the game right here and right now.
Oh, beautiful crowd control by Getchur Boy Dog in this position. Rosita Jones defiantly trying to make a stand and stay in the fight and somehow does it despite being so far behind this entire fight. Rosita hangs on by the skin of his teeth. Cyclone again at low health by Flop. Flop looking maybe to bash Rosita. Now jumping over to Whoopi. Maybe looking to exchange that. Maybe just looking to bounce around the fight for fun. Not actually engaging any crowd control. Now getting bashed himself. This could be a bit of a throwaway on the part of Flop. They switch some damage to him, but Baby Cakes protects him with that Ring of Frost. Definitely looking unfazed, even though it's his first match in the tournament on that Windwalker leading the charge. But Ice Block is available again and likely to deny the kill here in this position. If it's even necessary, the lead that Getchur Boy Dog got throughout the fight has been lost. Rosita has an answer, can deny the kill here, and likely has to. Touch of Death is huge. Rosita's going to respect that trade out Ice Block, now back in a similar position. Both druids out of mana at this point. Dampening has just started. Flop sneaks away to reset that Flame Strike snipe by Rosita. Great placement, great awareness on his part to know where Flop was, even though he went into stealth for that. Really nice play.
Yep, Flop finds the Cyclone on Whoopi. Rosita Jones all by himself. Ironbark was used. Whoopi has been doing a good job preemptively with these Ironbark before he goes in crowd controls, and it's one of the only reasons Rosita Jones has managed to stay along for so long despite the efforts of Getchur Boy Dog. So nicely done by him. Combustion available for Rosita Jones. Is there any openings? I mean, Grayson, he has one Ice Block left. He's going to be fine. With Baby Cakes has every single defensive. Whoopi now in paralysis. Interrupt on Rosita Jones. Diminishing return. Ring of Frost on Whoopi, but just the damage not available yet. Flop has to push in and get some crowd control on Whoopi or this kill attempt is lost.
I mean, they just need to coordinate together. They've had Rosita with zero cooldowns for basically the entire fight. So some cross crowd control on Omnivore and Whoopi, Polymorph the Warrior, Paralysis on the Druid, Leg Sweep on Rosita, Bash out of the Paralysis, chain all of these together and you're gonna get a kill. Flop goes for a Bash Cyclone, gets denied though by Rosita. Rosita carrying despite being at the edge of his seat the entire game with nothing, manages to pull it together for his team. Grayson is now down two Ice Blocks. He's an open target for four fun to stay alive in the series.
Yep, Rosita Jones has to play perfectly here. Polymorph spam onto Baby Cakes. Whoopi in a good position to stay alive and keep his team up, but mana is another thing. Both these healers almost completely tapped at 10% dampening. This is going to be difficult for them to get drinks off. Grayson with no Ice Blocks left. He opted to use one of his Ice Blocks earlier on as a trinket, and now for fun, they're taking advantage of that. There's a lot of pressure. In the meantime, Rosita Jones getting pressure down a little bit as he's looking for crowd control. Paralysis from Baby Cakes onto Whoopi. Rosita Jones getting lower. Grayson with nice cross crowd control on Omnivore. Full bash on Whoopi. Rosita Jones has to stay alive. There's the touch of death from Baby Cakes.
No way.
I don't know if he's going to be able to do it.
No way.
Cauterized Brox barely holding on, but that touch of death is the final nail in the coffin. And Getchur Boy Dog buries for fun like a dog buries a bone.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.